Good morning, you guys. Welcome back to another vlog.
Good morning. At the cabin.
At the cabin. We are freezing and we're going for a workout this morning, which is so hard to do when it's cold out.
Maybe it's just like more cloudy or something, but it's like not as bright as normal.
Well, it's just the gloom is setting in winter, you know?
So it's like our fourth or fifth night here. And we are loving the cabin life.
Yes, it's super fun. We'll keep you guys updated and give you updates later in the video on like how everything's been going. We've just been unpacking and it's been kind of a crazy week.
We thought that it would take us a while to get used to, but like from the first couple nights, it was like, this is our house.
Yeah, we haven't really felt like homesick for the other house at all. So that's been good. Yeah. But we are going to take our seed really quick before we go to the gym. We always take it right when we wake up. That way it kind of like settles in while we're working out, because you're supposed to take it 30 minutes before your first meal and
an empty stomach.
Our workout is 45 minutes, so we just take it right before we leave and
I come home and get coffee and breakfast and all that kind of
coffee
stuff.
Breakfast, it's great.
It's Friday today.
You guys already know seed, we're obsessed. It is a pre and probiotic combined to make their daily DSO1 symbiotic, and it's just so important for your gut health and your immunity, skin health, regularity, everything. Helps the whole system really work.
I mentioned in the last video, I've added it to like my routine to try to like have it stuck, so keeping it by my nightstand, all that kind of stuff. If I forget to take it in the morning, I always take it at night. You take it pretty much this around the same time every day, like either before the gym or after the gym with the one in the car.
I usually do, but we've actually been leaving this one out here. Like at the old house, we had it up in a cabinet, and I feel like having it out just on the counter, like right when you come into the kitchen in the morning, that's helping a little bit.
Haven't missed a day in the mornings. I say that. I haven't missed a day since being in the cabin because it's out.
Yeah, so maybe putting it out where you can see it or next to your water jug, like on your nightstand. That way you like won't miss it. You can also, I know some people take it at night before bed, so if you forget and you just wanna like pop it in at night as part of your night routine, just combining it somewhere where it makes it really easy is a great way to like
have it. Or if you're ultra organized and you have one of those like pill packs of all your vitamins you take every day, just pop your two seeds in there and you're good.
But yeah, just thinking about like health and going into the new year, I know that's always like a big topic of discussion. I think seed is something that you can definitely easily integrate into your routine if you want to kind of like start to think more about your gut health and your overall immunity. Like we talked about a couple vlogs ago, gut health is so affects your mental health so much. So they're really closely connected. So it's worth taking a look into seed and just seeing what it's all about, what it supports and everything.
And with it being the colder months, like going into the holidays, November, December, January, February, it's a good time to add something like this into your regimen.
Yes.
So you're just taking care of your body, your whole system.
Making sure.
Also, it would be a great gift for your partner. Maybe you're already taking this, like get it for your spouse, your boyfriend, girlfriend. A family member would be a really good Christmas present or gift for the holidays. Just show them that, you know, you prioritize health and they should also.
Yeah, it's just, it's the best one on the market, so.
It is.
You guys should definitely get it. They've done a ton of research and science on their product. They're like, hands down, it's the best. Anyways, we always have a discount code with them. We'll put it here on the screen. You guys can also just click the link down below. We'll have the code there to get 15% off your first order, I think.
Yeah, your first month.
Perfect.
Anyways, go check out seed. As you know, we love it. And let's get the day started.
We're going to the gym. Let's do it.
Dragging ourselves to the gym. Mm-hmm. It's so hard in the cold months.
It's rough.
But
if you can just get yourself in the car, that's the ticket. That's the hard part. And get just to the location.
You're just like tighter than normal when you get to the gym. Like I feel like it makes me want to do more stretching.
I know.
In the colder months.
Definitely.
Try to loosen up because it's not as warm.
You need to do hot yoga.
Hot yoga, sauna. I added sauna to my regimen recently. Yep. And it's nice. So nice.
Anyways, let's go hit it.
We're running late per usual.
We're in the cabin coffee nook right now. We just got back from F45. It is very cold. And I'm making us our current little Americano situation. So I'm going to show you guys how I do it, or what we've been doing lately. We have, Hunter likes almond milk and I like cashew milk, so I'm going to just mix them actually because we're almost out of both. That's what we got. This is the best brand. It's literally just water and cashews, water and almonds, so no additives. We go through about one a week each, so just between like smoothies, coffees, cereal if we want it, whatever. the best. We get it at Publix, so they might have it at Whole Foods too. So I'm gonna steam that milk really quickly. Then I'm gonna grind the beans. And then I'm making basically just a traditional Americano. So I'm gonna brew the espresso, double shot, and then add hot water. And then I top it off with about a quarter cup of milk each. So it's not really a lot. It's an Americano, but with cashew milk. So good. Cooker, where did you get those? Do you want to be hot, everyone? I bet they miss you because they're so stinking cute. You are so cute. How are you liking cabin life? You love it? He loves it, you guys. It's actually kind of fun because the house is smaller, so it's easier for him to get around and, like, you know. I think he really likes it. It's cozy. He follows me everywhere. Don't you? Yes, you do. Yeah, and there's a lot more wildlife at this house. We see deer walking through the front yard all the time, which is so cool. We saw a hawk the other day. We've seen, yeah, there's like two bucks that come through a lot, and doe, and like just the area that we're in is really wooded, and there's tons of like trees still, so there's a lot of wildlife, and it's just such a cool area. So that's been really special to kind of like have around. Like, I'm like, I feel like Snow White up in here. I love it. I actually watched Snow White recently, and she goes in a cabin in the woods. It's just such a vibe, so I was like, I need to channel this right now. I'm moving to a cabin and watching Snow White. Okay, so Americano, let me show you. It's not rocket science, but you know, I always like to see how people make their coffee because it gives me ideas. Okay, so we've got our Americano out there. And then I'm just gonna top it off with some creamy milk, get a little foam. Oh shoot, I used like all of it, whoopsies. Okay, and there's one coffee, donezo. I'm gonna do the other one. One thing that we don't have in this house is a trash can. We've gotta get a trash can, so we've been like leaving like a bag hanging on the wall. My goodness, you're beautiful. Ah! Okay. How does it feel to be so beautiful, huh? Is it foam? Everyone look at you. Love you extra special. You're so adorable. I don't really care about that. I love you because I love who you are. Yes, I do. Cute's just a bonus. Really, it's severe for me. Are you trying to figure out what's going on? Careful, you don't want to burn your nosy. You don't want to burn your nosy. My goodness gracious. How sweet is that? It's too much for me. It's too much cuteness. Too much. Do you want a coffee? You don't need none of that. You've got so much energy. All right, let's go. We gotta make breakfast. Come on.
Time for brekkie.
It's really hot. Okay, I just want to do a little bit of the sausage.
I want to do a lot of bit of the sausage.
Okay.
I'm not trying to take over. I thought I was making breakfast and you were making coffees.
Well, what were you gonna make?
I was gonna make breakfast tacos.
You were?
Yeah. What were you making?
I was making a scramble.
Oh.
With some vegetables. But we can make different things.
We can make a breakfast taco that has vegetables inside of it.
Perfect. Let's do it.
Is that a good...
That's a great compromise.
Compromise?
Let's do it.
Meet in the middle?
Mm-hmm.
I thought you could just sit back while I make breakfast.
I need some veggies.
What were we wanting to do with this spinach? This is your coffee.
I'm gonna stir that up. I just think some veggies would be healthy.
You mean do a scramble that goes in a tortilla? Or do we make it like how I normally do, where it's like you kind of build your own based on the items?
Yeah, I can cook the veggies separately and we can do whatever. Okay.
Okay, this is raw sausage. You can have any. Should we use two pans?
What?
For veggies and sausage?
No, I'm gonna cook the veggies in the sausage stuff out.
Oh, in the grease.
Yeah.
Greasy bitch.
Oh my god.
What?
Rude. Cookie. What do you think of your mom and dad cooking book? You love it? I know someone's gonna ask. This is Jackets from Urban Outfitters. It's Hunter's. It was in his men's Urban Outfitters haul on his Instagram. Oh, you should make a highlight.
Did I not call that she was gonna steal that from me?
Who?
You.
Yeah, I said I was gonna steal it. Told you right now. But let's catch up. So where was? Oh, our last vlog was. Yeah, the moving vlog, really. So you guys, we've been in an unpacking abyss. And it was no fun to watch, you guys, I swear. It was just literally like one box after the next, just dumping stuff out and like trying to find places to put it because this house, as you know, is much smaller than our last one. So we've been like just sorting a ton and it was a lot of clutter and like honestly, it was kind of stressful.
It was chaotic.
But we're a little bit more settled. We still have like a lot of stuff laying around. It's not organized at all, so don't
judge
us.
I feel a lot better though.
I do too.
About where things are at, but they're still far from where they need to be.
Yeah, it'll take a while.
But we're in a tough place to kind of talk about because
we feel like some of the furniture doesn't actually really fit that well, but
fit size-wise as well as like style for this cabin.
Yeah, and we're kind of like maybe now our vision's changing now that we're in here. We're like, okay, maybe we go like more just lean into the cabin aesthetic and maybe go a little bit more rustic. Some of the sizing isn't working as well, so we just have to figure it out. We need time to like sit down and really like look at the overall vision, but we just have been just trying to get our stuff unpacked and get the boxes out of here.
Our plan is obviously to keep as much character as possible. Yeah. Like that is what we're doing, keeping as much character. That's why we wanted this house. So I know a lot of people thought we're like removing the character. We are not, trust us, we're not.
No.
Just wait and see.
And like, we just need to, you know, it's been nice to even be in here for like a week just to have time to like feel like the vibe of it, and you have to like let the vision come to you. It doesn't happen right off the bat, so I feel like it's even changed since we first did the tour. We're like already have different ideas than from what we originally, you know, thought. So that's just the thing about projects like this, the ideas change and evolve. And yeah, so if you guys think of things too as we go, feel free to pop them in the comments if you're seeing like having little aha moments, but yeah, so.
Our goal is to keep the fireplace, keep the hardwood floors. I know that was a huge concern for everybody.
Yes.
We want to keep the hardwood floors, the natural floors, but we just want them to be uniform throughout the whole house. So we're going to explore all the options to make that possible.
Yes.
Whether it's sanding and restaining everything. The only reason we want to keep the wood floors, which would be a small chance, is if for some reason we can't sand them down and match them.
And also, I'm curious, at least close to I want to get somebody that's better at flooring to look at them, but they're pretty beat up. I don't know if they like need to be replaced. Like they're not, I don't know if they're...
They just need to be refinished.
Yeah.
They need to be refinished, restained, sanded down. But yeah, they are indeed beat up, but once you sand them down, you won't be able to tell.
Yeah.
It kind of like gives them a new life. We want to keep the fireplace as a fireplace if we can. I know we initially threw around some ideas like making it the range, which would be really cool. We also thought kind of about making it like a pizza oven. There's a lot of fun options, but we think it'd be really cool to keep the fireplace in the kitchen if it works with the formation of the kitchen. The room actually isn't that
deep
in size, and so we're gonna explore like putting an island or a kitchen table in front of the fireplace, but just wanna make sure we have like enough counter space and cabinetry. Right now we have 3 cabinets, we wanna expand that. So we wanna redo the whole kitchen, and if possible, after we iterate, we're gonna try to keep the fireplace, we're gonna try to keep the wood flooring, and we're trying to keep as much character as possible. So, don't you worry.
So we pretty much haven't been vlogging for like a week because we've been unpacking a bit. And we didn't really have anything fun to share. We've been like just ordering like Chick-fil-A and like to-go food because we didn't have like our kitchen unpacked, so we weren't cooking. We weren't really like doing like home stuff or like living a normal life. We were just like, yeah, it was chaos. So
there was a lot of unpacking, computer work to stay on top of our jobs.
Yes.
And we just went vlogging. So anyways, you we're guys, vlogging now.
You guys didn't miss anything. Yeah. We're fine.
But we've been here for a week now, and we're loving it.
We're loving it. Super cozy, and it got really cold, like, literally right after we moved in. So it's been winter.
It's almost like cabin weather.
Oh, I was telling them about all the deer that we've been seeing.
Ton of deer.
Yeah, which is cool. Like a fun experience.
One update that's more like on the sad note, on the sad side of things, is my grandmother passed away 2 or 3 days ago? Two days ago? She was 80, and she was like fully there, like, you know, fully present. Her mind wasn't gone, but she had a aneurysm on her heart, which we had found out maybe a month ago that it was like bigger than it should have been, and that they had really given her, like, they didn't really give her a timeline of like when it would burst.
Because it's like unpredictable, but they kind of suspected.
But they were like, you know, it's not going to be long.
Yeah.
I think after hearing that, everyone was thinking like 6 months to a year. But like 3 or 4 weeks later, it happened. So she died peacefully. And I think it's been pretty hard on my family. Because my family is like, we're all really, really close with my grandparents. And
your mom's first parent to go.
It's my mom's first parent to go. And it's really hard on my grandfather.
Mm-hmm.
I think he wasn't really expecting it. I don't think...
They were married 55 years or something?
Yeah, over...
60 years maybe?
Almost 60 years probably.
Yeah.
But he, I think, was a little bit in denial that it was like potentially going to happen so soon. So I don't think he was expecting it. It's been really hard on him. Anyways, we're going back to Texas.
For the service.
For the funeral and service. We're leaving Sunday, coming back Monday.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's like obviously really sad, but the last time we went back to Texas to celebrate her 80th birthday.
Yeah.
Like 3 weeks ago.
We did, we're so happy that we did that because we're like, oh my gosh, that was the last time we saw her.
Yeah, we got to spend like time with her, and you know, she was even kind of joking around like, you know, I'm okay leaving soon. Like, I'm okay dying. Like, I know where I'm going. I'm kind of in a little bit of pain from like all my internal organ like issues, but I'm ready to go whenever like the Lord's ready to take me. So I know she was in a good headspace, which gives me peace about it. And I think gives my family peace about it.
Totally.
But still, it's like obviously really sad and like a hard time. So, and she loved Julia so much.
She did love me.
She did.
We had a fun relationship. We liked her a lot. It's like, I don't think it's really...
she was always really good to you.
Resonated yet because we're not there. But I'm sure once we're...
That's what I told my mom yesterday. I told her that I haven't cried yet.
Yeah, I'm sure that...
And she said, like, it's because you're not around. Like, just wait till you see everyone. Like, she said everyone's, like, pretty shook up about it. Which I can imagine. I'm also pretty flat with my emotions, for the most part.
Yeah.
Like...
We're pretty stable.
Pretty stable. Even keel.
Yeah.
Which is, it's a good thing a lot of times in a lot of situations, but at the same time, it's like, I think I mask my emotions a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And so, every once in a while, like every 4 or 5 years, I have like a... almost like a breakdown because I keep all my emotions in.
Yeah.
So you know what I'm saying? And like, I hold on and then it, like, I need a big release and then holds up again for another 5 to 10 years and
totally.
Whatever.
But, well, it doesn't seem to affect your daily operating. Like, you seem to be fine.
Well, with her specifically, I feel like she would want everyone to continue to like live and love their life and have fun and enjoy. And she even said, when she passes, she doesn't want people to like
be sad.
She wants to be celebrated.
She was always super fun. Yeah.
She was so fun. Had the best like positive energy and spirit.
Yeah.
She was like such a good person.
She was.
She was the one actually. I give her credit for getting into fashion when I was like in middle school.
Yeah.
She like really supported me dressing how I wanted and. You know.
I forgot about that. She would take you shopping.
She took me shopping when I was little.
So cute. she loved fashion, so
yeah, she loved
that
it.
That was really fun. We would always talk about that.
She loved fashion. She loved jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
She loved her online shopping.
She loved her online shopping.
She loved her online shopping.
She was a shopper.
Every time we'd go visit them at their house, there'd be like packages on the front porch of stuff she would order off QVC.
Oh, yes.
But,
aw. Rest in peace, Gigi.
Yeah.
Poor Gigi.
I mean, it's weird that she's gone, you know.
I haven't really thought about how sad it's gonna be when we go.
It's been really sad.
You know? Like, seeing everyone else really sad is gonna be hard. That voice.
That's what's hard on me.
Yeah.
I can't see someone else cry, or that.
That's Are you looking for a different tool?
Yeah. It's always weird when you lose somebody, or like when a family member passes away, because there's not really a right way to handle it.
And you won't really know until you experience it, like mm-hmm. how you'll feel. Doesn't like everyone grieve differently?
Everybody grieves differently. And for me, I almost haven't processed it yet. Maybe because I am like 9 hours away.
Yeah.
But I think it's okay to process it how you want and in the time you want. But in general, death is like a weird thing.
It is.
It's like, so all of a sudden it's like life goes on. You don't want to have that attitude, but you almost have to have that attitude.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, and that's like when your faith and like spirituality comes into play, because it's like knowing she's in heaven and you can still like, you know, you can still talk to her if you want.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
But I think the best thing you can do is just like celebrate their life.
Yeah.
You know? And take things from their life that they probably hoped to have passed on.
I imagine that, like, I've never really lost anyone like that close to me where it like messed me up, you know? Like, it's always been like my grandparents was close to them, but not where it like wrecked me. So, like, I'm sure,
mm-hmm.
but I imagine that, like, having a death like that that's really impactful, like, changes you in a lot of ways, which is cool. Like, it gives you perspective on life that you wouldn't have before.
Yeah.
Whether it's, like, more gratitude for, like, family or, you know, just that time is short, stuff like that, you know?
I almost feel, like, bad for being at peace with it.
Feel bad.
You know.
I mean, I think
I'm not at peace with that. I'm not at peace with that. I'm more of like, I think I was like slightly mentally prepared.
Mm-hmm.
Just because like, we don't see him as often as the rest of my family.
Mm-hmm.
And so each time I would see her, I would kind of tell myself, like, this could be the last. Like,
you were expecting it.
Yeah.
I think it'll also be different. Like, it'll be way different when it's, like, I hate to talk about this, but, like, your own mother.
No, I know.
You know?
So, I mean, it's
that will be, like, really.
I can tell it's really hard on my mom.
Yeah. This is, like, a big one for her.
And so, like, for me, I don't feel responsible. But my mindset and approach is like being there for my family members and being a more solid
support system.
Yeah, rock or support system for them.
Yeah.
So, anyway. Amongst the chaos of the move and all of that, this was the news we got.
Mm-hmm.
And it really puts into perspective, like, we're pursuing these adventures and doing all these fun things, but family, friends, all that is so important.
Yeah.
And at the same time, it also encouraged me to continue to pursue our passions.
Yeah.
Because it shows you how short life is. So,
totally. and she would have wanted that.
Yeah,
she 100%. Always was really supportive.
I like remember the day I got the call and my mom told me. My mom was on the way to the hospital because I think they were trying to resuscitate her. That might be a little too much, but she was on the way to the hospital, called me, and I remember like instantly I was like, my instant thought, it was almost like something inside of me, it was like, keep doing your thing.
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget to tell your family, I love you.
Yeah.
Call a friend or family member if you're thinking about them.
You just never know.
And pursue a life that makes you happy, because it, like, tomorrow isn't promised. Yeah. Anyway. We love you, Gig.
Love you, Gig. Day whatever of unpacking, I've lost count. I'm working on the guest bath right now, and I think it's actually gonna come out really cute, so I'm just gonna show you as I kind of did it. Hunter and I just put up the shower curtain. There's already a pull here, so this little linen curtain is from RH. Doesn't need to take down, that's the previous owners. But this I'm most excited about. We've got this antique piece that we got, and it was upstairs in our last house, and it's actually like a shop counter, so the other side is the side you would actually see, but there's shelves in the back, so we turned it around, and I'm gonna fill that with towels and like make it cute. I think it's gonna look really good, so just thought I would show you at least the process of this unpacking situation. So let's do it. I'm thinking a mirror in here would be cute. Let's try it.
Open the door. Alrighty, folks.
Okay.
We are trying to wrap up what we're taking to storage and what we're keeping here. It's also
once
hard because, like, okay, that piece over there, it feels really, like, dark and, like, it doesn't go in here.
I know.
But it will once the renovations are done. You know what I mean? So we're trying to keep things in here that we think we'll keep once the renovations are completed in, like, a year.
Well, everything is just, like, thrown out right now. I don't want anyone thinking like this is like our formal decorations, because it's absolutely not.
Mm-hmm.
So just, you know, withhold your opinions.
We're trying to make use of the items that we want to keep here.
Yeah.
Once the renovations are completed, but make use of them now temporarily. Like for instance, this couch. Actually, I think we'll take this to storage. We should need to borrow a friend's truck to load it up.
Yeah.
I
just like really, it is really hard for me to just bring furniture from one house to another and just expect it to be the vibe. I just never feel like that works.
Yeah.
Even when we brought some of our furniture from our Texas house, I was like, it doesn't work. It's just not each place has to be kind of decorated in its own way, I believe.
It has its own uniqueness.
Yeah.
And its own style.
And sometimes you can make certain things work.
Yeah.
Like,
but I mean, really, if you think about it, everything we made work at the new house it was all, or at the Nashville house from Texas, it was like things thrown in a guest bedroom or things thrown down in the basement. You know what I mean?
I know.
It's more like we can make decor work, but the furniture itself, it's almost needs to be custom to the place that it's
in. I kind of agree. So we're not really feeling any of this. Dining setup's not bad.
Yeah.
But so it's just pretty much, I'm looking at it as like furniture. We're just going to kind of live on temporarily until we figure out a new design plan.
Yeah. But we're trying anyway, to just like we're going through all the lamps right now. Just all the pieces that, like I said, that we want for when the renovations are done. I don't think we'll keep this in here at all.
No.
We will want the Sherpa couch.
We love our antique piece over there. Yeah,
that piece over there.
We'll do a little full little updated tour just so you guys.
Let's just do it right now.
Well, okay, I want to put this runner down.
Okay. But we have the dining table. It's looking good. And all of the logs, the plan is, and I don't want to speak our plans like too much right now because we get so much judgment or thoughts towards everything we say we're going to possibly do. But for us, everything feels so orange that we want to restain, and these have been stained once before, and you kind of stain them multiple times like to keep them up. But we'll want to restain them, I think, more of like the chocolate color to match the beams in here, and just go with like more of a darker vibe.
Yeah.
But
we just don't love the warm color. It's hard to decorate on.
The antique table and the chairs will look good once the place is renovated.
Yeah.
We just don't want it to look too much like a like old grandmother's house.
Exactly.
Or too much like a lake house that's like a temporary visit. Like, we want it to be something modern, but still keep the character.
Yes.
So when we say modern, we don't mean we're going to make it look like just a normal house.
No,
we mean
the decor.
A modern play on the log cabin.
Correct.
So
I'll put some inspo pics here on the screen. I showed some on Instagram stories, and I was like, I feel like it
makes sense.
Yes.
Yeah.
We're still keeping all the character, but just making it a little updated.
So it's like taking the cabin, but like updating it. Not changing everything, but updating it to make it more livable, more desirable. So like down the road, future investment, if we want to sell it or rent it out or whatever we have plans for, it is something that's desirable for someone to want to buy.
Well, this is the thing too, is the other direction we could go. It's hard because you can go a lot of different ways. Like, we could go super Ralph Lauren with it and like just lean in and like do all the like patterns and textures, or we can go a little bit more modern. Think if this wasn't our everyday home.
Right.
If we had like a cabin in Colorado, then I would just go hard on like Southwestern prints and like shit like that. But like, having it be your everyday, I just don't know.
Because this is already an older house and it's already a log cabin and it has a lot of character and neat features to it, I think we can create a nice juxtaposition by adding modern elements to it.
I agree. And I don't think that's really been done a ton. So to us, that is the most intriguing, and we are the ones that are designing it. So there's a lot of different directions you can go. I know a lot of people are like, no, like go this way or that way. There are tons of paths that you can take. But we go with the one we feel most passionate and excited about, because we are living here at the end of the day. So
yeah, all the opinions and suggestions, we all love. We appreciate
like to hear
it. We like to hear the ideas. But we have a vision in mind, and it's just going to take time to achieve it.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, we'll just show you,
because I know a lot of you guys have asked. You want to see.
It's kind of a mess. Okay. This is, I feel self-conscious showing this, because I'm like, there's nothing really to show. But this is the couch from Hunter's office, and our Sherpa couch, which we have in here. We need to lay down a rug. This antique piece, we're able to place in here. It fit perfectly on this wall, so we're very happy about that. That will probably stay no matter what.
A sectional in here.
Yeah.
And then we'll move the Sherpa couch probably to that front guest bedroom.
Yeah.
Maybe that middle. We need to figure some things out.
Definitely.
But it's weird because it's like, we know the furniture we have right now isn't going to be what's there.
I know.
It's temporary to have seating, to have like while we're watching TV.
Totally.
Like, but at the same time, it's like, what furniture are we actually going to use? What room is it going to go in? The couch is in that little living room between this room and the primary. They're probably too big in there.
I think so too. We'll show you.
We can use them temporarily in here, maybe.
I know. We might rotate them around, but it's still, like, we don't even have everything, like, out yet. Like, things are on the ground, so we haven't been able to, like...
Is this room cozy, though?
Oh, yeah. We have this, our old entryway table in here, and that fits nicely. We just need to decorate that. These are our Jenny King couches that we had downstairs, and they actually look good on camera, but they're a little tight. Like, this is they're a little big. Like, you can't really walk back here that well. It's a little bit crammed. It's a little crammed over here, but it's not bad.
It's just too big.
I know, they're just too big.
Because it's nice, like, this format is nice and this formation.
Yeah.
But it's narrow because you have doors on that side.
I know.
And you have doors on this side.
I know.
So,
they really actually look good, though.
I'm thinking almost just more like a chair room. Like, a cool, like, multiple chair setup or something.
I know.
We'll need to play around in here.
Definitely. And then we've got these chairs here on the edge. This is probably the best setup so far. But, yeah, the scale is just a little off.
Again, it's a little bit small. We haven't touched these things. This is just where we told the movers to,
like plop them. Things. Yeah. I mean, there's stuff everywhere. We need to take those to storage. Okay, we have all of our Christmas decor still out there, which is wild. The primary, which is so messy right now, is pretty good. So we've got the poster canopy bed from the guest bedroom, which we love, and same with the nightstands, our old dresser, and two chairs right here, which are covered in clothes. But yeah, this feels good, don't you think?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, especially when it's clean, it looks better.
We answered a couple comments about people saying we should keep the fireplace. This fireplace, it's not like real antique wood, it's fake antique.
Yeah, it's like
there's a lot of pieces that are like paint. Just super glued on, and some of these pieces down low are like plastic.
Yeah.
And so it's just like fake.
Yeah, it's not like a real like vintage.
It's not character. Cool. This thing was installed like 2 years ago by the previous owner.
Yeah.
She only lived here for 2 years and she had put this.
And they just like layered it over like this stone. So like I think we could get something that would actually add a lot more character, would be really cool. Yeah. But you know, we'll see. This is why. And bathroom, still got all of this I need to move. We've just got full carpet in here. That was the desk from my old office, which I'm using as a vanity right in front of this little window right here, which is perfect. You can look out to the trees while doing my makeup, which is nice. Sorry, still unpacking all of this. But yeah, little bathroom. And actually, we've been quite impressed with the closet. It's been pretty good so far. Actually, I haven't felt like it's been too cramped, don't you think?
And one thing I did notice is we never had nightstands that had drawers. And so we actually have way more clothes storage.
Yeah.
Because we have like all of our underwear, socks. I have all my workout gear in mine.
Yeah.
And so it's like kind of in its own section versus being like crazy in the closet or in the dresser. And then we have more like everyday stuff like shorts. Stuff like that, jeans, pants,
and dresser. These are actually dressers. They're like smaller dressers that we're using as nightstands. We wanted bigger nightstands because for this bed, the old room that we had, had this bed in was so big it needed a little bit. So just so happens to be perfect. So
perfect.
Yeah, so now we have extra space. But so
I've actually enjoyed that.
Same.
It'll help us over time be more clean. Once
definitely.
We've
got all of our shelf decor just smacked on there. We have to style them.
And this is shelf decor from the upstairs guest bedroom from that little shelf unit we had. This is from both of our offices, and this is from our living room.
Yeah.
And from books we had in the kitchen. Like, this is just everything thrown up here. So we need to organize that. We've got all of our Christmas stuff.
I know, showing them.
On this porch. Oh, you already said that?
Yeah. Okay. I know. That's why I didn't really want to show too much of to you guys because it's just such a mess. Okay, and then this wing of the house.
This was one of the guest bedrooms. She actually had it as an art studio.
So yeah.
This house is a 3-bedroom. It's the primary and then 2 guest bedrooms. She had it as an art studio. We're probably going to be using it as an office.
Yeah.
And we sold one of our beds and we'll be storing another for the new build. And then we have one more guest bedroom down the
riverbend.
And this is actually last thing I'll say about this room is this feels the most cozy to me.
Yeah.
Because it's the most open right now.
Well, has the least crap in it. Yeah.
But there still is a lot of junk in here.
So
we
much.
Clean it out. I think we're going to take a lot of the lamps. We need to figure out what we're going to do with all the lamps.
Yeah, that was your lamp gallery.
Yeah.
Gonna have to figure that out. There's a little bathroom right here. Off the side, which is actually a really nice size bathroom. This looks cute. We have this little piece in here organized with towels and stuff, mirror, put up a shower curtain, and I think I just want to paint this. I just get some paint and like paint that like beige.
We could take that down in here probably if we wanted,
but yeah,
I think it's cute. The least of our
It's pretty nice and like with just some paint and I think some more decor and it'll feel perfect. And then this is our old bed from our last room, and all of my extra linens are on there right now because there's nowhere to put them. There's not a linen closet.
You showed this in the last vlog with the Brooklyn.
Yes, I put all the Brooklyn and bedding on there.
We have the bedding and stuff on it. We just need to remove all the extra linens, take them to storage. We're about to do a storage run here in a second. And our extra closet with all of our jackets.
Yes, is where we're putting all of our coats. So that worked out and has been perfect little use of space. This bathroom's cute. Perfect little guest bathroom. Got some towels in there, rug, so that looks good. Got some siding right here.
And the art, I feel like I need to say once again, these are not like where they're gonna be.
Hunter just threw up art everywhere just to get it on the wall.
Well, there was already hooks on a lot of the walls. It's and so touch. I've just gone around to like get out of the way. I've just like
put
art up, just to get off the ground. The art that we're wanting to maybe keep for this house in the long run or long term, so I'm just getting them on the wall. Because they're already hooked. She left all the nails in the wall, so
Just
throwing things up.
And we're just going to have to kind of play musical chairs and rearrange everything. But, anywho, so short of the updates.
I'm going to take that one to storage, that Chris Coleman, like, Christmas tree.
Yeah.
I was like, it's kind of perfect for Christmas time. Not necessarily right there.
Yeah.
But I like the...
I know, we need it. We're trying to get everything just sort of away so we can at least get up like a Christmas tree. I'm thinking about hanging those back in the entry, but we got to get to doing some stuff. It's just been a long process. It takes forever.
We should hit the storage unit before it gets too dark.
Okay, let's do it.
Freaking stool going to storage.
Yeah.
I love that piece, but...
We still have a spot for it right now.
It's a little heavy in here for right now.
And our storage is really close, so we're just taking everything that we're trying to... clear this place up, guys, because we need places, just need to be able to breathe because there's a lot of clutter.
I'm gonna text our friend for some of the bigger pieces who has a truck that we can take the storage.
Oh, yeah.
The storage unit's 10 by 10, so we got plenty of room to just like throw couches in.
Yeah.
Even some of these like heavy wooden pieces, that was the coffee table in my office.
I know.
I think like maybe for now, I don't know.
Which I would love that in the new build, it'll be great. But so that's why I think we just store things temporarily.
And we can always...
Well, it might look cute once there's like a sectional in here.
And a rug and stuff.
Yeah, I just don't know. We have to wait.
It's just also hard because like we're still figuring out what we're going to do with the floors, like what we're going to stain them after we try to sand them down, stuff like that. So
everything has to happen in phases.
Just be patient with us. This is only like day 4 after the move and we are trying to work through it as fast as we can.
Yeah.
But it's a process.
It is a process.
So... let's get going. We have our car full right now. We're gonna keep adding some stuff to it, but I have my amp for my guitar, my electric guitar I'm gonna put in storage for now. I'm gonna keep my acoustic here. There's no way in hell Julie was gonna let me keep this here. It's just like too rustic at the cabin for now. Yeah.
Storage unit. Mostly storing a lot of our artwork that's not gonna fit. Got this guy here. This is the first art piece Hunter and I ever purchased. Here we go. So we got mostly art in here. Linens. I have a ton more linens I need to bring. All of my pillows have way too many pillows. So not bad. And I think we'll put the couch in here probably sideways. But storage is nice to have for sure. We can't fit all of this art in the cabin, so you know we had that gallery wall. So we're gonna store it.
I love all of our art.
I know, and art is like you wanna keep it and like sacred.
Alright, fam.
Tie.
Cozy in bed.
We're in bed.
I just put moisturizer on my face, so it's really shiny. And I shaved, so it's smooth as a baby's bottom.
Slick. Hunter's been slugging. He's been putting on, well, he didn't even know what that was intentionally, but he's been putting Aquaphor on it because he said his skin was really dry.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, you're slugging.
I always put my eye cream on, but I just started putting Aquaphor on my face here. And then underneath when I shave, just to keep it like moisturized. Because it can like get really dry.
Or do you put on regular moisturizer first?
No. Not at night. Mm. I put moisturizer on during the day, but not at night. I've been putting Aquaphor on instead. I switched. Or I replaced it with Aquaphor. But anyway, we are leaving first thing in the morning to go to Texas to my grandmother's funeral. And figured we'd say goodnight, everybody. We went to dinner tonight with friends. We went to get ramen.
So good. It's been so cold here. I think it's been cold kind of everywhere. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been seeing some people visiting Alice Beach, and it's like cold down there even.
Really?
Like 40 something, yeah. So I think it's just a cold front.
Yeah, it's for sure a cold front. But since we're a little bit more north than Texas, like what we're used to,
yeah,
it's colder here. It's at least like 10 degrees colder here than it is in Texas.
Yeah.
That's what we figured out today.
10 degrees, baby.
So it's like 20 to 40 here. In Texas, it's like 30 to 50.
Yeah.
But it's been cold in the mornings. Anyways, we went and got ramen at a place called Black Dynasty. Our second time to go there, and it's so freaking good. It's like the best ramen in Nashville, in our opinion.
We were all like, silent, like slurping our bowls. We were all like going ham. It was so good.
But it's at the Bearded Iris Brewery. I believe it used to be somewhere else. Black Dynasty did, and it closed down, and they reopened it up at the Bearded Iris, I think is the situation. But anyways,
it's so yummy.
So good. Would recommend.
Really, really good.
Would recommend if you're in town visiting or if you live here, check it out. But if you're in town, go there, have a beer or two at the brewery, and then get some
It's a good place to go ramen, if you're visiting.
For
it's
sure.
Different.
It's cozy, too.
Like, more of a local vibe.
It's first come, first serve, so.
Yeah, on our list, we recommend local spots to people.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. But anyways, hope you all enjoyed the vlog.
Mm-hmm.
Julia we'll be back is with another. Dead. She goes to sleep so early. Since we've been here and it's been cold, she gets in bed so early. And like
I'm on an early schedule.
Cozies up and just crashes.
Yeah, I'm like asleep by 9 every night.
She'll be like, you want to watch a movie? And I'm like, all right, sure. Let's, if you can stay up for it. And
you've been going to bed. Like, we would go to bed at the same time, but you just stay up a little later, like 9:30, 10?
I've been going to bed like at 11.
Oh, really?
10:30, 11.
Oh.
Yeah. I end up watching like a documentary or something.
So I'm like asleep for a while.
Yeah, like at least an hour.
Oh.
Yeah.
Dang.
But she'll ask me to put on a movie, or like if I want to watch a movie. And I'm always down to watch a movie with her. But we'll put one on and she's out in like 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Like, literally 5 minutes. And I'm like, babe, you chose this movie. It's Lindsay Lohan, or it's freaking a Christmas Hallmark.
Yeah, we watched the Lindsay Lohan Christmas movie the other night and that was really good. I liked it. That was actually cute. It wasn't that cheesy. I mean, it's cheesy, but like, not as bad as the holiday
asleep.
Fix up.
She fell asleep, and I watched it by myself, and then the next morning she woke up and finished it.
The holiday fix up. We started it last night, and I fell asleep halfway through, and I was going to wake up this morning and watch the other half, and then somebody made me go to the gym.
I did not make you.
I know.
I even said I would bail and hang out with you this morning.
I know, but like, you didn't want to go by yourself, and I didn't want to do that to you. So
I said, whatever we do, I want to be together this morning.
I know, that was really nice.
If you don't
want
to go to the gym.
I like to blame you.
After you said that, I was like, okay, maybe we don't go to the gym. That kind of sounds nice. And then you were like, no, let's go. And so you kind of motivated me to go.
Really?
So motivated each other.
Okay. It was actually good. I just pulled a butt muscle, so like I'm like a hater right now because it hurts. You tired?
My neck just hurts.
Oh, okay. All right, you guys. Well, we'll see you soon. We gotta go to Texas. We're not gonna vlog that.
Obviously,
I just need some family time.
Yeah.
And then we will be back for Thanksgiving next week. We're so excited. Friendsgiving, and then Vlogmas is starting.
We get back Monday night. We'll probably vlog Tuesday. We'll probably pick up back. We're in the vlogging spirit again.
Well, and we're doing Vlogmas. Did we tell them?
I mean, I've been saying it.
Did you guys know that?
I don't think we've told y'all yet. Oh. Like, officially.
Yeah.
I think we said we're wanting to do it, but
we're not trying to overthink it.
We're doing it.
So we're just heads down doing it.
But yeah, we're back in the vlogging spirit. We're feeling really good about vlogging and having fun with it. And excited to show, like, the house. Like, it's almost hard because I think we want to show the progress, but we're doing so much here at the house.
Yeah.
So we're like, oh, let's show it all, but on... If it's just like little updates throughout the vlog, it's not like it's
feels
that much
like
progress.
Boring to
it feels boring.
I know.
So it's like, do y'all really want to see that? You know what I mean?
I know.
Which I'm sure y'all do.
And it's just like messy right now. Like, I don't feel like it's like cute. I know you guys want to see like
how we're decorating it.
Right, we're not there yet. Decorating it yet, though. Like, it's just leftover stuff from the old place. But
we wish we could snap our fingers and it'd be done. But we can't.
No.
So just bear with us, hang with us, and hopefully y'all enjoy the process. We'll try to make it as fun for y'all as possible.
Oh, also, some people asked when we would start renovations, and I said probably in the new year, because I don't think it's realistic to get contractors in here, like, during the holidays, like,
yeah,
when everyone's traveling and stuff, right?
The plan is that we'll have all of our plans
finalized, done
before the new year. We'll commence work in the new year.
Yeah.
But we'll be working through our plans probably throughout Vlogmas.
Yeah.
We have a lot of ideas. We just have to put it all together.
Did you wash your hair?
No.
Oh, that was good.
Yeah, but I had it done last night.
Did you put some hydrating cream in it?
I put a mask in it.
Oh, good. I'll say. After your...
Oh, yeah, I had my hair done last night.
Your highlights, I would say you should keep it really hydrated because it's going to keep drying.
Mm-hmm.
And then your curls won't be as curly.
Yep. But... All right, y'all.
All right. See you soon. Next week for Thanksgiving. Excited.
Yeah, I got a brand new Benz. Crazy, right? Brand new Benz. Got less miles on it than I do friends. Remember when we laid in you and Paige's crib? Was there so long I could have paid rent. Remember when we couldn't get shit? Best thing about being broke is you don't spend shit. Remember that Christmas? We had a wish list. We couldn't afford nothing, but we still get shit. Ironically, those were the times I felt the richest. All the times that we spent by the pool, girl. Was too broke to...